It's amazing to have you here with us at Showmasters. Have you been enjoying meeting Cobra Kai fans here in London?
Oh, yeah, it's been awesome. It's so cool getting to meet everyone, take pictures, you know, posing and fighting stances with everybody. It's awesome. I love it.
Can you talk a bit about what, for you, is the timeless magic of The Karate Kid and how this series has really brought that legacy to life for a whole new generation of fans?
I think almost all of my friends love, all my friends do love the show. I think the magic for me just is working with Billy and Marty every day. They're so cool to work with. I mean, just seeing them together in scenes and then also having scenes with them is really, really fun. I was really intimidated when I first got on the show because, you know, there is that legacy of The Karate Kid and the fans are so dedicated. But I'm it's really cool that everybody loves it. I mean, the guys who write the show are the biggest Karate Kid fans ever. So there's definitely a lot of Easter eggs and stuff like that for the hardcore fans, but it's also really easy for new people to get into the show, which is awesome.
I mean, it's not hard to see why you'd want to be part of this project, but talking about the character, can you talk a little bit about his evolution and what it was about him as a character that you were most excited about as a storyteller?
Yeah, I mean, this kid really goes from zero to hero, I think, especially in the first season. I was bullied a lot as a kid, and like, that just sucks. If you've ever been bullied, you don't want to go to school. You don't want to do anything. And I think it's cool to show a story arc of a character who, you know, is bullied a lot and is a loser at school and this and that and that. And he joins Cobra Kai, and, you know, that Cobra Kai mentality really works for him. And he goes through this whole transformation, becomes like this badass hawk, you know? I mean, it's just really cool to see. And it's also so much fun to play. I love how the writers will bring back Eli, and you still get to see the underneath of Hawk, and that at his core he still is a little bit of that, you know, shy, nerdy kid. And there's almost nothing wrong with that. But in another way, he is Hawk and is badass and is almost a villain.
So we have to talk about the hair. Can you talk a little bit about the process of crafting that very unique look? Because it is your real hair.
Yeah, it's all my real hair. At the end of the season, I cut my hair really short because it's all just dead, bleached hair. And I just grow it out. Like, right now, it's just growing, waiting for season three. I get the buzz sides, bleach on top. Then it goes black, whatever color it's going to be for third season, I don't know. And then, the color, black tips. It takes a while to set up. It takes about a good 30 minutes to an hour, depending on how fast we go. And I'd say most of it is hairspray. It's almost all hairspray. It all gets teased up, and it's a bunch of hairspray, and that thing's hard as a rock. There's nothing that's going to bring that thing down.
And obviously, season three, we're so excited. You're starting work on in September. I'm curious, given where we left everyone at the end of season two and the events of that season, what are you most interested about getting to explore as you keep going with that character now in these new episodes?
I definitely say more scenes with Sensei Kreese. That'll be really fun to see. Johnny's out of the dojo as of right now. And so I think it'll be cool to just see more and more influences from Kreese and just how that affects Hawk. That'll be really cool to see. I just think the relationship between Dimitri and Hawk, you know, more tension there is going to be really interesting. I know that I don't know a lot about season three yet. I know that there are some more Dimitri Hawk scenes. I don't really know what they entail, but I'm really excited for that.
I mean, I'm curious, if you got to write your own Dimitri Hawk scene, what would you really like to see from those characters? Because obviously, that tension's very real.
Yeah. Honestly, I would love, this is probably more a long game. I would love to see a fight between them where, of course, Hawk wins. But I would really like to see them come back together because, that is his only friend his whole life, you know? And so I think it's almost sad for him to have to go against him, but he does just because he's so opposite of his Cobra Kai beliefs and morals. Even the comic book scene in season two where, you know, they're chasing after him, there's a line that Gianni does, who he plays Dimitri, he's like, "You would really hit me?" It's like, oh, dang, like, yeah, I'm sorry. But yeah, I think that would be cool to see them, like, rebuild at some point.
Talking about Johnny, obviously William's here today. Can you talk about what makes him such a fantastic talent and how much you think this new series has changed people's perception of a character from the original films? Because obviously that viral video that explored Daniel-san as the bad guy really made an impact with people, I think.
I I don't know, for me, when I watched The Karate Kid, I didn't have this overwhelming hatred for Johnny. I don't know why. And I think that the Johnny that you see now was, like, the same Johnny. Like, you know, I don't think there was, like, too much of a change in him. He's just an awesome dude. He's so cool. You know, he walks around on set with his glasses on, and, you know, he's just Billy, and he's the coolest guy ever. He's really fun to work with. That guy is a legit karate master, you know. He like, even on set, we'd be like, yeah, like, tuck this, tuck that, you know, move around a little bit. Coaches us while we're on set with the stunt coordinators, which is really cool. He's a blast to work with. That guy has a ton of lines. He is constantly, you know, I mean, he's the lead, so he's, like, constantly saying, like, what we're doing, all this stuff. That guy always has his lines down flat. He's very, very, very professional.
On a show that's so action-packed, I'm sure there must be a few mishaps, a few actual connecting kicks and punches. What's been the funniest or perhaps the most painful part of that for you?
You know what's funny is we've never really had a lot of accidents fighting. The only time we've had an accident was me and Xolo, the kid who plays Miguel, we're walking through a doorway, and we play this game where, like, you go like this to make someone flinch, and it's two for flinching. You hit them twice. And he tried to hit me and just clocked me in my nose super hard. Instantly started bleeding. That's the only time I've ever been that accident has happened on set. And it wasn't even a fight scene. It was just we were walking through a doorway and he just miscalculated his hit and just totally decked me.
Do you have a message to all of those Cobra Kai fans who cannot wait for season 3?
Flip the script. Stay badass.